Hey guys, this is JT from VibeTCG, and I'm here with my deck profile from the Detroit Michigan Regional. I got 13th place, and I know it's not top 8, but it is my first event since the 200th, as well as my first regional since 2018. So, like, this event actually means a lot to me because, you know, I didn't expect to do well. I'm not gonna lie, it's my first event back. I didn't get to playtest at all much. I think I played with this deck maybe 3 matches and then 1 match on Dueling Book before IP came out. So most of this deck was theory. So like it really means a lot to me. And I just want to shout some people out. NATO, man, thank you so much for lending me like cards, man. I appreciate it. And I appreciate you just always telling me like you can do good. Sam the Win, thank you. Also, you lent me cards. I sent you my deck list. Theory with it. You also talked to me once I got to the convention center, and like, yeah, if we would have played, you definitely would have smoked me. You had me gone. Like, you had the gas game one, but good thing we got a repair. Zach, thanks for helping me out with testing against Infernoid, as well as lending me cards. I really do appreciate it. Antoine, thank you also for lending me the bombardments. As small as they may seem, they had a huge impact, so I appreciate it, and thank you a lot. You also talked to me about the deck, and you told me some things, and what you thought, so, like, I appreciate that as well. Cedric, thank you, man. You hooked me up with the IP. Like, the IP was the MVP, so, like, I appreciate it. I also appreciate that you just look out, man, and, like, I just appreciate it, so, like, thank you. Like, you also helped me test, man. Yeah, I know. You beat me in testing. Yeah, whatever. And then Anthony Wilkins, man, you told me, and I was very surprised. It was at Jake's Memorial Sunday. You said, "Yo, do you want to go to the regional?" I said, "Yeah, but I don't have a deck." And you came through and you said, "Yo, you want to play Orcus?" And without any like hesitation or anything, you pulled out your deck boxes and you literally just said, "Here's Orcus cards." And yo, I appreciate that more than you ever will know. You told me you wanted me to do well, and like, I just appreciate you, brother. Mariah, same thing, man. You just came through with cards and cards and cards, and you said, "Here, take these and do well." You helped me theory. You helped me playtest. Like I said, I only playtest this deck, this version of the deck, realistically, three matches. So, like, I learned everything in a night that I was going to learn about this deck as far as IRL testing. Everything is theory. Austin, good looking on Succession and just being a homie. Like, I really do appreciate that you came and talked to me. You kept me level-headed. Like, I appreciate it. Kyle Jones. Listen, Kyle don't share deck lists with nobody. So, like, the fact that, like, you shared your deck list with me and you came and talked to me, I appreciate that more than anything. Justin Singh, I sent my deck list off to him, and he looked at it, and he told me his thoughts and opinions on it, and I changed some things, I capped some things, but I really do appreciate the help, man. My boy, Jake Lackey, man, listen, he always tells me stop playing these terrible decks and play good decks, because I have, for some reason, I feel like I have to play, like, bad decks, and it's just me making an excuse. It's me, like, building an excuse before it happens on why I don't do well. So, from this point forward, I'm going to play, like the better decks. And, like, I'm going to actually listen to him. And I'm going to try to do the best I can playing the best decks. I'm going to test a lot more. I'm going to theory a lot more. And I promise you, man, I'm not going to let you down. Because you believe. Zach Sidetack, bro. Hey, I sent Zach my deck list. He sent me back another deck list and told me my deck list needed this. And I explained him my concept, and then he got on board with it, and he told me, like, "Yo, I think you can do it." That's how Zach talks, man. Like, and then Zach showed up at the regional clutch round 7. So, like, yeah, man, it's good seeing you. Brandon Miyake. This guy is a genius. Nobody knows it yet, but he is a genius. Like, he is some top-level intellect type stuff. Like, man, he is like Alien X when it comes to like deck building and stuff. Like, Ben 10, you feel me? Like, he's just there. Like, the deck list he wanted to play, he couldn't get the card he needed. But if he would have, I think he would have been in definitely in the top 8 because he got some next level stuff coming. Also, look out, it's going to be an FTK coming via Brandon. Miyake coming sometime this week, so look out for that too. Lincoln Petries, he messaged me, I think it was this week or last week, and he said, yo, I'm going to help you get ready for regionals and the grind and stuff like that. And I said, what do you mean? He said, I'm going to help you. And I said, what do you mean? He just said, I'm going to help you. So, like, thank you, man. I appreciate it. Like, I really do. Because, man, Lincoln doesn't play as much, but, like, he wants to see us do well. So, like, I appreciate it. And last but not least, Paulie Aronson. I sent him my deck list. I asked him what he thought. Yeah, that was loud. I asked him what he thought, and he responded. He let me know what he thought. He told me, like, certain things he really liked and certain things that he didn't like so much. So, I appreciate that. Also, I got to meet the great Rami Dari at the regional. It was really nice meeting you, man. You're a really cool person. And everybody at the Fun For All family, like, if I see you and you spoke to me and we hung out or talked, yo, thank you. Everything that people said to me made a difference. And if I would have top 8 it, it wouldn't have been my top 8. It would have been our top 8. Just remember that. Because every little thing that someone says or does, it influences how you look at the game or how you perform at the game. So let's hop into this profile. First off, we did Hand Trash 3, Ash 3, Deacrow. I thought Deacrow was necessary just because Jesse won with Lunar Lights. And I expected people to try to replicate that. And a lot of the Hand Traps aren't good. So, like, against that, because I just make it as a thought. So, I wanted to play the Crow, so after they go Chicks and Martin, I could just Crow the Martin if they go Tiger. And then I could, like, make them have to commit more resource. For the Orcus cards, to play 3 Nightmare and Juan. Listen, Juan is... What the hell is this? Juan is a nightmare to me. I mean, Orcus to me. Like, it does, like, pretty much the same thing. So, they do. 3 Harp. 2 Bombardment and 1 Symbol. And the reason I played that ratio is because I felt like Symbol wasn't that good unless you had an Orcus in hand. And even if you were able to get it out with another monster, it still didn't do much. And Symbol only was good once you got your play started. So I didn't want to max out on either one of those, and I didn't want to play more than one Symbol. So, like, that was my thought process behind that. 3 Scrap Recycler, 1 Greffer, and 1 Armageddon Knight. I thought Greffer was subpar. Like, unless you have more dark monsters, unless you have dark monsters in hand, like, it doesn't become that good. I know you play all dark monsters pretty much, but, like, you don't really want to pitch Crow unless you absolutely have to. And if you pitch Crow and get Ash, you feel like you just lost a piece. And, I just didn't think it was that good. I wish I would play Mathematician here as well, somewhere. Rotor to Search the Warriors. 3 Return. Return was like nuts. 3 Insta Fusion. I was only playing 2 Insta Fusion at first, but then I thought about Nibiru and I wanted to play that so I can get out Winda. 2 Cyclone. 2 Mind Control just so I can have some good cards going second. 1 Babel. 1 Foolish. Foolish is nuts. Can never be at more than 1. I expected to get it on the ban list very soon because every deck is playing Graveyard. Monster Reborn and Succession. I wanted to play those cards. I wanted some recursion. I wanted a way to get back my cards. And if I open, like, subpar, or if I open, like, in a scenario, shut up, phone, please. I don't want to put you in airplane mode. Or if I open, like, Arma Knight, and it gets, like, Ashed, and I have a way to still bring out an Orcus card, like Foolish or something, an extender, I can always link for, like, IP, bring back Armageddon Knight, and send another card to, like, keep playing. And 3 copies of Impermanence and a Crescendo. Onto the side deck, 3 Lancia, a Scythe, 2 copies of Phantasme, 3 Twin Twister, 3 copies of Sanctum, and 3 DD Grounds. For the extra deck, we played Winda, we played 1000 Eyes Restrict, 2 Ding, 1 Boral Sword, 1 Topological Bomber Dragon, 1 Long Grisu, 1 Topological Trisbane. We played Unicorn and Phoenix. 3 copies of That Girl Galatea, or That Guy Galatea, I don't know what it is. IP, which is probably the best card in my extra deck, and a copy of Link Remo. Now, I know this card you guys are saying, whoa, where's Nibiru? So, I came to the conclusion that since everybody's playing around Nibiru, I thought it was going to be Lunalight heavy, that I did not want to play Nibiru. I just thought it was, like, not good. I didn't miss it once. God damn it, phone. I didn't miss it once. It didn't really come up much for me. Like, a lot of people, like I said, were playing around it. My hand trap stopped them from summoning, like, more than, like, you know, four times. So, like, it just didn't come up for me. So, like, I don't think I would play it in this, not necessarily I wouldn't play it, but I don't think I'd play it as long as I thought Moonlight. Like, YCS, London's going on. If Moonlight wins that, I'm not gonna play it. Just because, like, it's just, to me, it's just a brick. Like, I'd rather have cards that can actually do stuff, like the Crow that makes them burn resources, or that permanents that, like, can go through the, you know, as a thought and still stop other plays, or the Ashes shit, cause that's just, like, universally good. Also, Super Poly. So, if you look at my extra deck, it's really tight, and I didn't want to add, like, fusions in there just in case. So if I would have had to play Super Poly, I would have had to side the fusions. And I didn't want to do that because I didn't really want to take anything out of my extra. I thought my extra was pretty perfect. So that's a big reason why I didn't also play Super Poly. Now, I know everybody's looking at the deck and they're like, yo, but what can we do if we can't afford cards like Impermanence and Phantasmic? And like returns going up. I got you. Now, the only cards I think you can't like change are like Dingrisu and IP. So like, you're gonna just spend the $25-$30, whatever they are, and like, it is what it is. I'm sure if you buy it off of somebody, you probably get them for like 20s, you know, probably can like haggle somebody, get them for 20s. But in permanence, you could take that out for like Chalice. Like, it does similar things. It doesn't let you like stop them from like setting up their big board going second. But your hand traps can help you do that. Like, Crow can, like, really make them burn a lot of resources and potentially not end the way they want to end. So, Crow can do that. And as far as Phantasmas, you can probably just take Phantasmas out and play, like, another Ghost second card. Or you can play cards like Virus, like, the Virus card, I forgot, Eradicator. You can play Eradicator. Like, that can also, like, help you out a lot. So, you don't necessarily have to play these expensive cards if you can't afford them. You can, like, see, you cut a return for maybe a Mathematician. That way, you can play around cards like there can be only one. So, yeah, that's what it is, guys. And like I said, guys, this event meant a lot to me. It's my first event back, and I will be going to more events, guys. And that's about it. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and as always, feel the vibe. Later.